Good morning children, welcome to the class. Okay, yesterday we have completed up to temperate grassland nature. Now, people who will live in temperate grassland are the prairie grasslands are called the wheat baskets of the world. Okay, the prairie grasslands are called wheat baskets of the world. The farmlands here produce enough wheat for the entire country and export it too. Okay, here the wheat farms can produce enough wheat for their whole country and they will export to other countries also. Wheat and meat are the staple food here. Okay, what is the staple food in temperate grasslands? Wheat and meat. Cattle rearing, agriculture, dairy farming and mining are the common occupations in the temperate grasslands. Okay, what are the common occupations here? Cattle rearing, agriculture, dairy farming and mining. Okay, these are the main common occupations here. People who take care of cattle on ranches means large farms in North America are called cowboys. Okay, people who take care of these cattle they are called cowboys. People wear heavy woolen garments in winter and cotton clothes in summer. Okay, what they wear, what these people wear in winter is woolen garments and in summer cotton clothes. Okay, now see page number 35. Deserts are dry areas with very little rainfall and very little or no vegetation. They may be hot or cold. So, okay children, these desert areas are dry and they have very little rainfall and they have little or no vegetation here and it may be hot or cold also. Okay, next, climate. Most of Saudi Arabia is in the torrid zone. Okay, most of Saudi Arabia is in torrid zone and is covered by desert. Okay, the Saudi Arabia is fully covered by desert. Temperature are high during the day and very low at night. How the temperature here? It is very high during the day and it is very cold at night times. Sometimes there is no rain for several years. Okay, sometimes there is no rain for several years. So many years they don't have rainfall also. Due to lack of water, Saudi Arabia has developed a technology to remove salt from sea water and make it suitable for drinking. Okay, due to lack of water means they don't get rainfall heavily or it may be several times there is no rainfall for several years. It may be no raining there. So, they have improved a technology to remove salt from the sea water and make the water for drinking purpose. Sandstorms are quite common here. Okay, sandstorms are quite common here. Nature. How is the nature in Saudi Arabia? Plants that grow here have long roots that grows deep into the soil in search of water. Okay, plants which are grown in these areas have very long roots because and they grow here, they grow deep into the soil to search water. Okay, animals such as camels, jackals and foxes live here. Animals, what kind of animals will live here means camels, jackals and foxes. They can survive on very little water and food. Okay, these animals can survive with very little water and food also. And oasis is the only fertile part of a desert and is formed when underground water comes up to the surface to form a water body. Many people live near an oasis. Okay, only oasis is the only it is the fertile part of the desert which is suitable for when the underground water comes up. So many people live near oasis only. Okay, people, rice, meat and different kinds of bread are the staple food of the people in Saudi Arabia. Okay, what is the staple food here? Rice, meat and different kinds of bread. Okay, so in Saudi Arabia, the staple food for people, staple food is rice, meat and many kinds of bread. Oil drilling is a major occupation here. What is the major occupation in Saudi Arabia? Oil drilling. Okay, people here wear following clothes that provide protection from hot desert, wind and sandstorm. Okay, people who are living in this country, they wear the following clothes which they can protect themselves from heat and desert winds and sandstorms. Okay, next. So open page number 36. Open page number 36. Now we will learn about equatorial forest. Equatorial forest or tropical forest lies around the equator in between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, climate. The Democratic Republic of Congo is in Africa. It is located in torrid zone. This country is located in torrid zone, which is in Africa. A large part of this country is covered with forest only. The climate temperature, the climate in Congo is pleasant with bright sunshine in the mornings and very high temperature in the afternoons. This is followed by heavy rainfall with thunder and lightning in the evening, making the night cool. Okay, the climate here, the temperature here is, it is very pleasant and at morning times it is very pleasant and they can experience bright sunshine. Coming to the afternoon, it is very high temperature at afternoons. Coming to the night times, these people can experience heavy rains with thunder and lightning, and the night will be very cool. Okay, next. Nature. The forests here are evergreen. Trees remain green throughout the year. Okay, the forest is evergreen. It never dries up. Okay, the trees remain here are green throughout the year. Tea, mahogany, amboy, bamboo, banana, palm trees, plantain, coconut palm, coca plant and rosewood are some trees found here. Okay, in this region we can find teakwood, amboy, mahogany, bamboo, banana, plantain, palm trees, coconut palms, coca plant and rosewood. These type of trees we can find in this climate. Gorillas, parrots, cuckoos, sunbirds and herons are some commonly found here. Okay, what we can find commonly here? Gorillas, parrots, cuckoos, hippopotamus, elephants, buffaloes, leopards, poisonous snakes, insects, we can find here. Okay, now coming to the people, pygmies, some of the shortest people of earth live here. Okay, earth's model shortest people live in this forest region. Okay, we call them pygmies. Okay, their height they are usually about 120 centimeters tall. The height helpers help them to walk easily in the forest, in the thick forest. Okay, maize, banana, groundnut, and cassava are the we can find plenty in this area. Okay, what are they? Maize, bananas, groundnut, and cassava. Okay. People dry the roots of cassava and make grind them into flour, and they make bread with this flour. Okay, people here, people in the forest wear light clothes to suit them warm and in humid weather. Okay, so this is the lesson for you today, children. Okay, bye. We'll meet in next session.